Programming is difficult, but if we keep doing it, it gets easier. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Programmer for Life, programming for everyone and everything. This is the second part of three part video series on command line arguments in Python. In this video, we are going to use the getopt library, which uses options as a way to accept command line arguments. So let's get started. So we are in the directory command line Python. Let's create our file getopt-tutorial.py. Okay, so let's start by importing the libraries. Okay, so first I will import the sys library and then I will import the getopt or getopt, whatever you want to say. And after that, I will only take the arguments except the file name. So I will store them in argv. So I will use sys.argv of 1:, right? So this will accept only the arguments except the file name. So now remaining code must be written in a try-catch block. So I will write the try-catch block here. Okay. So in this try-catch, try-except block, more like in Python, we use except statement. So we will accept the for getopt error. So getopt.getopt error. What this does is it checks if the options are not recognized or if the options are not shown in the correct format. Right? So we'll print the error message here. Okay. Now let's write the comment so we can recognize why we are going in this section. So if options are not recognized, if any option is not recognized, then we will go in this section. We will get an error basically. Now the error message which we will receive on the console, let's say we will print one or more options if one or more options are not recognized. If one or more options are not recognized or they are not in the correct format, so we need this when any option expects a value and I do not give a value, in that case I will get this error. Or if I require only two options and some third unknown option is specified, okay, so in that case also it will go in that section. Now we'll write the main line, getopt.getopt. So first argument will be argv, second will be short option, and third will be the long option, right? So in second argument we'll write the short option, which means what options we expect from the arguments, and long option are the longer version of the same short options. Okay, so let's remove the syntax and write the actual options that we are expecting. So for short option we'll have u:p:. So basically we are writing the code for username and password verification. So the username and password verification will need two options, u and p. Now u means here username and p means password. The colon here means that a value is expected. You can have the options which do not expect any value also. In this case we need a value, so we'll write a colon for that. Let's write the long options also. So we'll write uname equals for username, and we'll write password equals for password. So here equal to means that it is doing the same work as the colon, right? So let's write for the password also. So we'll write password equal to, since we are expecting a value for the password. Okay, so after that, before writing any statement, let's store the results in options. And so two results are actually returned by this statement, options and remaining arguments, which is specified after the options. After that, I will try printing these because we will see how it varies and how depending on the input it changes the options and arguments, right? Let's also print the error in case the number of options specified are not proper. So we'll also guide the user by printing the usage so he can understand the next time he gives the arguments, he will give the correct usage, use the correct usage. So in usage, I will write the file name first. Okay, now next the minus u option to specify the username, and then lastly minus p for the password. The user can also use long options for writing the arguments. So I will copy this line and paste it here. So let's make the changes. So minus u will be replaced by minus minus uname. That's how we use the long options. Okay, we use two hyphens in front of the option. So same for the password. We'll remove this or sign. So that's it. We did the usage. Now this code is done. Let's try various things on the terminal. So first I will execute this file using without giving any options getopt.tutorial.py. So I will see the usage directly showing to me. So how I can use this arguments, and we see empty list printed. Let's give them options. So minus uabc and minus p 1 2 3 4. Let's follow the usage. Okay, so we see the output as options as in the form of a pair. So we can see option and value, option and value pair. So minus u has a value abc and minus p has a value of 1 2 3 4, right? So we don't see any extra arguments here. Let's try giving some extra argument and see what the output is like. That's def. So we can see that the next list is not empty anymore. It has a value, which is the extra argument. Okay, now let's try one more thing. Now we will give this extra argument at the beginning. Okay, sorry, minus p. So right, now let's give the extra argument at the beginning and let's see what the output is. So we can see there are no options recognized, and we can see the usage is printed to us, and also the various arguments are directly in the extra argument list, right? Now let's remove this extra argument and let's try to give some wrong option. So we can see now that one or more options are not recognized is printed. So this was actually going to be printed when it goes into the get opt error, but we don't see the usage, so user will get confused what to print, what to write code, so that he doesn't get this error. So let's make the changes. Let's print the usage also when the user gets the get opt error. I will make the indentation changes. All right, so that's done. Now let's try re-executing this. So now user will get the usage also. He will understand what is going wrong when he executes the code. Okay, so now let's move on to our task at hand. So we need to verify the username and password. So we'll write the code for username and password verification here. Okay, username and password verification. Before we write the code for that, let's first declare outside the try catch block the correct username and password. Okay, so outside the try catch block, we can make the variables accessible and visible just after importing the libraries, right? So let's write the correct username as my name Varun, and I will give the password as 123456. So correct password is equals 123456. Okay, now one more thing, we need to extract the username and password that the user typed in the command line arguments. Okay, so we need those username and password values. Okay, so the options are stored as in a pair, that is value for an option. So option followed by value. So that pairs we will use that for writing a for loop. Okay, So I will for each iteration accept an option and a corresponding value in arg, and I will check the option. If the option is equal to minus u, then I will write username. Okay. So if the option is minus p, then I will write the password. Right. So let's also give the long option. So minus uname and minus password. Okay. So I will also check if option is equal to u minus uname or not. So if opt is equal to minus uname. So if user type the long option, then also we will get the value of username. Same for the password. So opt equal to minus password. Right. Okay. So that's done. Now let's write the code for username and password verification. Okay. Here in this part, we will write the username and password verification code. So I will check for username first. If uname is equal to username, correct? I don't remember what is the variable name. So I will copy from here, correct uname. Control C, and I will paste it here over this variable. Control V. Okay. And in the similar manner, we will check the password also. So password equal to correct password, correct underscore password. So if the password and username match, then we'll print username and password are correct. Username and password are correct. If that is not the case, then in the else part, we'll copy this line and we'll write, we'll just make a small change. So password and username and password are incorrect. Okay. Let's check one last time if we have written the correct. Okay, so correct username and password are declared, and we have written the verification code also. Okay, so we are good to go. Now let's try executing this. Okay. Let's give the correct username and password first. So it shows the correct output, username and password are correct. Now let's try giving the incorrect username and password. So for that, it shows username and password are incorrect. So that's it for the second part of Python command line series. Hope you enjoyed it. The code links in the description below. If you like this series, then consider subscribing to stay tuned for more content. Hope to see you next time. Until then, have a good day.